This video contains harsh language, specifically English. Warning, the following video contains opinions, and they could even be contrary to yours. Please remember that even in the heat of the moment, it's about opinion. If you watch the whole video and you still don't agree with me, well, feel free to sound off in the comments, just
don't be a shit-asses.
Opinionated mates.
Oh, hey, little chirper. They're recording right now, so no one's allowed in. We're only insured for bird staff. Letting you in would be a liability. Don't even think about sneaking inside. Young lady, if I catch you in the studio, you'll receive a ticket so big you'll
it be is.
Dead for
it's
years.
Jontron. It's Jontroversy.
Young lady, if I catch you in the studio, you'll receive...
Young lady, if I catch you in the studio, America should be totally made up of white people. Ha ha!
Jontron, the supposed white supremacist, racist neo-Nazi. His voice appearance in Hat in Time is still in the game. And what's worse, social justice warriors are trying to start controversy over it. Because Jontron's voice is in the game. I was streaming this game earlier today, and I didn't even notice that it was Jontron until viewers pointed it out to me. Voices are voices. I must say, Gears for Breakfast deserves extra credit for not dropping Jontron from their game. But now, they need to keep that in place and not remove him with a patch. My message to Gears for Breakfast is simply thus. Don't give in to social justice warriors. They are loud, but they are not numerous. The smallest groups are often the loudest, and social justice warriors will say, "Oh, if you keep Jontron in your game, I will not buy your game, and none of my friends will buy your game." But here's the thing, they weren't going to buy your game, and neither were their friends. Stick to your guns on this one. Keep Jontron in the game. Because right now, there is a nice group of people on Twitter congratulating you for keeping Jontron in the game and not for bowing to SJWs. And those people congratulating you have purchased the game. They are paying fans. Don't worry about what some super self-absorbed social justice warrior thinks on the internet. When what you've put out, what I have been playing today, is one of the smoothest, most comfortable, most enjoyable platforming experiences in forever. And by the way, may I say it right now, Gears for Breakfast, your game is like 5 times better than Yooka-Laylee. It's at least 5 times better. You really hit the nail on the head. You got exactly what you were setting out to do. You set out to make Super Mario and you nailed it. You fucking nailed it. Don't let a good thing go to waste. Remember why you added Jontron to this game. Remember why you sought him out. Because you love his work. You love his videos. And he's a fan of the very platforming games that inspired you to make what you have made and what you have released. Don't let some loud-mouthed, cock-gobbling fuckwits on the internet make you change your mind when you know that the reasons you included Jontron in your project were wholesome and honest reasons. Even if you believed Jontron was a neo-Nazi, white nationalist, super racist, even if you believed that, I think it's important for us as people to separate a person from their art. To separate a person from what they make. The people who can separate a person from their art are the people who have bought your game, and they are the people who enjoy your game. They are the people that you should be paying attention to. Not some dismissive corner of the internet that's looking to vilify you for no real reason. Keep up the good work, Gears. You guys fucking nailed it. Now don't give in to the pressure of social justice warriors. You're so much better than that. So much better than that. I see bright things in your future, guys. Bright things.
But that's just my opinion. What's yours?